Another useful feature which we're going to spend a little time on is summarization, which is taking text or a document and then truncating it down to the bare facts. Now, these are the options we have for summarization. So up here, you can change the model dependent on the engine you're using. Then here, you can change the default style that is going to be used when you perform a summarization. Is it going to be text? Are you going to have a bullet list? Are you just going to summarize the key points? Or perhaps, if it's suitable, you could have them placed into a table. Or it could be based on whatever you type here into this custom prompt. Now, this is the default one that is installed as part of your DEVONthink upgrade. And it certainly works for me, and we're going to see this in action very, very soon. Let's take a look at it working. So in this meeting transcripts group, I thought it would be quite fun to imagine how it would be to be a fly on the wall in the Beatles' first meeting as they were planning their first album. In fact, let's change this view so that we can see a little bit more of it. So of course, I got ChatGPT to create this and it did a great job. I can just imagine Ringo saying, "Hey, do I get to sing on this thing or what?" And I'll bring the sandwiches again. It's great, and this is actually quite a fun little hobby that I have sometimes, just creating mock-up documents like this. But let's summarize this one. So with it selected, I'm going to come up to Edit, then down here to Summarize via Chat. We've got the sections that we saw in Settings, so this is the text summary. Then here, when I click, you can see that we have this summarized into a bullet list. Then next to that, we have the key points, and you can see it's not taking too long with this engine to be able to create them. This is a fast one. There's a table here, which isn't ideal for this particular type of document. And then finally, we have the custom prompt, and that's going to be here. And I do really like how this looks as a summary. So once you have your summary, what can you do with it? Well, you can replace the transcript with this. Now, I don't want to do that. We can add the summary as an annotation to the file, and we are going to look at this shortly. And then here we can add it as a comment. And these are two definite viable options. Then on the right, we have our usual suspects of reloading the prompt. We can copy this particular summary and we can save it to a file as well. Now let's take this a step further. So here we have a similar file, but this is for Fleetwood Mac's first meeting for their debut album. Now over here in the chat, I'm going to type in a prompt. Draft me an email containing the key points from this document. Now it's analyzing the text. And then here we have a result. And there's a question at the bottom. It says, would you like to add or adjust any details before sending? So yeah, I think we will. Let's put in an address. Address it to albums@screencastsonline.com. Okay, can it do that? Looking good. Although we have another question at the bottom. Would you like to send this email now? If so, please provide your name or any additional details you'd like included. Okay, I'm going to put from Brian Epstein. I know he was the Beatles' first manager, not Fleetwood Mac's, but I haven't got a clue who Fleetwood Mac's was. Although I guess I could have asked ChatGPT, really. But there's our draft email ready to send. And it was all done from within DEVONthink. Really efficient. Okay, let's move this on even more and take a look at how we can work with multiple files. So I've got three files here. One for the Beatles, one for Blur, and one for Fleetwood Mac. And what I want to do now is get a summary of all of them. Because there may be times where you want to perform actions on multiple files. Well, I'm going to select all of them. I'm going to come up to Tools. And then down here, I'm going to summarize documents via chat. Now here we have four options. The output can be in Markdown format. It can be in rich text. We can add it as an annotation or as a comment. I think I'll skip over Markdown in this video and we're going to go for rich text. Now I'm not going to pause. Let's see how long it takes. And that wasn't long at all. We have a summary here. And if I hover over this title here, we can see that it links back to the source file, as indeed does this one. And here, in fact, if we click, it takes us to the source. It doesn't physically take us to the source file in the database. It opens up in our window here, which means I can click these navigation buttons here to move my way around. And at no point am I leaving this file. Okay, let's move on to where I think these summaries can really help. And this is something that I actually do day to day in my day job with meeting minutes, and that's using them as annotations. And over here in the inspector window, I'm going to click on this first one, which shows us the file information, and then this annotations section. This shows us any annotations that are attached to this file and any comments. And of course, we have neither so far. But we're going to change that now. And if you're unsure what an annotation is, well, it's going to be clear very, very soon. So with the file selected, I'm going to come up to Tools, then down to Summarize Documents via Chat. And this time I'm going to do it as an annotation. Now this does take a little bit longer, but not too long. We can see here in the inspector, we have our summary added as an annotation. And where does this annotation come from? Well, it's actually a separate file stored up here in this new group that's being created. So these are now intrinsically linked. We can see the contents here, and this is what appears in the annotation section of our source file's metadata. Pretty cool. And they really are linked. In fact, if I delete this and come back to the Fleetwood Mac file here, you can see the annotation is actually still present, which might make you think, Lee, they aren't linked at all because you've deleted it. Well, the annotation file is actually sitting in the trash, which this file can still see and reference. If I come over here, I'm going to right click and do what I need to do here to empty the trash. Now, when I go back to that source file, we can see the annotation is indeed gone. And it's a very similar process to add a Finder comment to the file, although this doesn't sit as a separate file. I'll summarize this one to a comment. Now it's very small, but there is a comment speech bubble there. And the text is in the comment sections of the file's metadata. And this is useful because this is now, of course, fully searchable within the DEVONthink database.